Hello everyone, my name is Jocelyn and I am an online teacher. I teach with platforms such as Outschool, Cambly, and I also have a few of my own private students as well. In today's video, I am going to be talking about three online tools that I find extremely helpful in my online classroom. As a new online teacher, it can sometimes feel a little intimidating trying to get started and figure out which online tools are going to be best for you and engaging your students in the online classroom. I am here to help. Let's break it down and talk about my three top online tools for engaging students in the online classroom. One of my top tools for the online classroom has definitely got to be Canva. Canva allows you to do so much, and it has a great free version that allows teachers and individuals to try out the platform, see how they like it before committing to a subscription. And the best part is you can always continue to use the free version. Unless you decide to upgrade, there is always that free option for you. So let's see what I like to use it for. One great use for Canva is to create different presentations. This is just an example of one of the presentations I created for my Spanish class. It allows you to add really fun and interactive images that are easy to move around the screen. You can change fonts and have access to different templates if you need some assistance with the design aspect of your creations. Another great use for Canva is creating worksheets for your classroom. I have created board games, different mazes, as well as other activity sheets and bingo boards for my classes. I find that Canva really elevates the way that my presentations and worksheets look in my classroom and just gives it a more professional feel, all without the hassle of going on Google, trying to find images, seeing if I'm allowed to use them. Everything's all in one place and super easy to use. That is just one of the many reasons why I love using Canva in my online classroom, and I definitely suggest it to other online teachers looking to create very professional looking presentations, activity sheets, and games. The site wordwall.net is one of my top go-to platforms for creating fun and engaging games. Wordwall allows you to create fun and interactive games such as spinny wheels, random cards, open the box, where students can choose different numbers and then an image or a text will appear, as well as many other activities like flip tiles, matching pairs, and many others. Wordwall is not particularly expensive, which also makes it great for teachers that are just starting out. They do have a free version. And if you do decide to pay for the subscription, the first level is roughly around $6 a month, US dollars. Another online tool that I find very helpful to use and engage my students in the classroom is called Nearpod. You can find it at nearpod.com and you can create a free account, which will allow you to play around and test out the different features and see if this is a tool that you would like to use in your classroom. Let's take a look at a few of my Nearpod favorites. So one of the great things that Nearpod allows you to do is create virtual field trips. You can take your students on different field trips to different places around the world, and they can have fun exploring these new places virtually. Another fun activity that you can create on Nearpod is upload one of your Canva creations or one of your worksheets, and you can have your students complete it directly on the screen. Nearpod has also created different fun games like Time to Climb, where students are challenged with different questions, and each time they get an answer correct, they climb higher up on the mountain. This is just another example of the fun and interactive games you can create using Nearpod. You're also able to create interactive quizzes, which your students can complete asynchronously or alongside you live in class. They get prompted with a question here, and then with different answers. They have to choose the answer that they think is correct, and then proceed to the next question. Once they complete it all, you get to see their answers so you can gauge how they are doing with the different material. This is a great way for them to complete an activity, and it's only for your eyes. The teacher is the only one who will see it, and so they don't have to feel judged by their peers during the class. So those are just a few of my favorite things that you can create with Nearpod, and I find that it's a great tool to really engage your learners when you're teaching them online. You can create games, you can upload worksheets that they can complete by drawing directly on the screen, and the teacher's able to watch and gauge how their students are doing in live time, which is wonderful. There's also a feature on Nearpod which allows teachers to send out presentations so students can complete activities and games asynchronously, all while you can still get real-time results of how they're doing with the material. So it's great for hybrid models as well as when you want to present something live to your students. So Nearpod is definitely something that I highly recommend for teachers to use in their online classroom. And there's a free version, so you can always test it out, see how it fits for you and your classroom and teaching style, and see if it's something you want to invest in the future. So those are my three top online tools to use in the online classroom. Let me know in the comments section below which one you found most helpful and which one you are most excited about incorporating in your online classroom. If you are thinking you might want some more guidance and help as you begin to learn how to use these tools and incorporate them in your classroom, feel free to check out my website, teachingeflnomad.com. And sign up for one of my workshops where I talk all about how to use Canva, Nearpod, and Wordwall in the online classroom. And of course, if you enjoyed this video and would like to see more, hit that subscribe button and give it a thumbs up. Thanks again for watching. I hope you found it helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them down in the comments. And I look forward to seeing you again in some future videos. Bye for now.